It's Friday. Let's have some fun this Friday flow. Lift your heart up, bring your hands to the fronts of your knees, lift up, stretch the spine upright, lift the heart. Take a couple breaths here, really kind of puff up your chest. I didn't check my list. If anybody's new, I'm Maeve, thanks for being here. Good, and then just start to soften the heart. Start to soften the ribs. Neutralize the spine, turn the palms up. And breathe. Full inhale. Full exhale. First few breaths, it's just you breathing, you settling into your breath, onto your mat. And then we're going to start to refine that breath. And it's not just breathing. Yes, it is. Like, especially initially, it's just breathing. But then start to breathe into the back ribs. And I always think of like spreading your wings out. The back ribs are like wings and you're spreading them out. And then the exhale just softens. So it starts to go a little less in the belly and a little more into the back ribs. Into the side ribs, and then softening in. So breathe like you are an angel and you are spreading your wings because you are an angel. And as the breath starts to even on the in and on the out, my hope for you is that you start to feel that evenness, not just in the breath, but in your demeanor and how you feel here right now, how you feel about your body, about your mind, in your body, in your mind. Always remember that this practice isn't about how well you think you're doing the poses. It's how you approach the poses. We are observers of our reactions, of our mind, of our breath, of our body, how we think about our breath, how we think about our body, how we relate to our thoughts. And then when you are ready, come around onto your hands and your knees. I'm going to face you, but you can turn on your mat like you normally would. And you're gonna take your right leg out to the side. I'm gonna mirror you. Your toes are forward, your hands are fully rooted. And then in this position, you're gonna do a few rounds of cat and cow. Dig that right foot down, push the top of the left foot down, or you can tuck the toes and push that down. And then come to a neutral spine. Take your left arm, reach it up. Oh, my back just cracked. Thank you. Take another breath in. And then threading this arm under and over, release your temple to the ground. Maybe take your right hand and put it on top of your left palm so that your hands are in prayer and you're stretching your fingers toward your right foot. And pressing the top hand into the bottom hand toward the ground. How is your breath? Good, bring your right hand under your right shoulder, push down, lift up, pause. Take the hands a little bit further forward and then pick up that right leg. Maybe shift forward and start to bring that leg toward your arm. Your left knee is still down. Two more breaths. And then bring the leg back, reset in the center, left leg out to the side, and then cat and cow here. We are not just moving our bodies, we're moving energy in our bodies. We're moving our mindsets. Come into neutral. Inhale, right arm up. Exhale. Thread under, reach over toward that foot. If you want, put your left hand on top of your right hand, press the palms together, pushing that top hand down toward the floor. Strong left leg, dig the foot down. Take the top hand under the corresponding elbow or the shoulder. So left hand under left shoulder, push down. Bring the hands a little more forward. Lift up that left leg, maybe come forward and extend that leg out. And then take the leg back, tuck your toes, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your heels right away. Exhale, roll through your spine, round the upper back like you're in cat's pose, stand the balls of the feet, and then come into upward facing dog on the balls of the feet. Chin to chest, round the back. Roll all the way back into downward facing dog, pressing the heels toward the floor. Do that again. Purposefully lift the heels, travel up through the legs, through the spine. Follow it through. Supporting from strong thighs to sky. Biceps back, chin to chest, and take it back. One more time, lift, roll. And then push it back through the spine to downward facing dog. Right knee, right tricep. Step it back, downward facing dog. Left knee, left tricep. Downward facing dog. Inhale forward, exhale back. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Right knee down the center, inhale. Exhale, place your foot. Stay hands on floor. If you have blocks, use them. Draw the front foot toward the back foot toward the front foot. Powerful left leg. Yes. So beautiful. If you have blocks, continue using them. Straighten the front leg. Consider lifting up the front toes. Toes down, front knee bends, back heel roots, reverse warrior. Bring it up and back. One more inhale. Bring your hands down to the ground. Plank, inhale. Chaturanga, exhale. Upward facing dog, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. Left knee into your chest, place your foot forward. Hands stay down, use blocks if you have them. Gaze draws a little forward, heart draws up and forward. Front ribs gently into the back ribs. Be that angel, breathe into those back ribs. If you're using blocks, keep them straight in the front leg. Consider lifting the toes of that front foot up. I'm gonna ask you to be really confident today. Like you're the teacher. Because you are. You are your own best teacher. Front toes down, bend the front knee. Whoa, reverse warrior. Reverse warrior. That wasn't confident, but it was correct. I was about to say warrior two. We can be confident and still be students. We can still learn and be confident. It's when our ego kind of like pushes in the way that we lose those student eyes, those fresh new eyes. We don't want to lose that, but I want you to be super confident. One more inhale, come around. Step it back, move through vinyasa. I personally believe that having confidence gives you the ability to learn more. To grow. Because it gives you some freedom. Rise high to your toes. Bend your knees. Bring your feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. Fold, exhale. Rise, inhale. Bring your hands into your heart with your exhale. We flow. Inhale, rise up. We flow with confidence. Exhale, bowing down. Inhale, halfway. Chaturanga, exhale. Inhale, rise. Downward facing dog, exhale. One breath here. Lift your heels, exhale, stretch back on no breath, feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale, fold, exhale, rise, inhale, hands into your heart, exhale, inhale, lengthen up, exhale, bow. Halfway. Chaturanga, heart to sky, lift the hips, down dog, stay for a breath, lift those heels up, bend your knees, feet to your hands, halfway inhale, fold, rise, draw to center. Gather, rise, empty and bow. Offer your heart, Sangha. Heart to sky, down dog. One full breath. Lift the heels, bend your knees, feet to your hands. Halfway, fold, rise up, inhale, and draw into your heart. Let's go one more, inhale, exhale, Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, right leg back. Exhale, knee to tricep. Inhale, back. Exhale, left tricep. Inhale, back. Exhale, place your foot. Pull the heart forward, stretch the arms forward. If this feels too much, maybe hands at your hips or stretch the arms back. You have not lifted the spine up. The spine is still tipped forward and a similar angle to the back leg. We're gonna start to straighten the front leg. Hands maybe float. Maybe they float. Yes. Reverse warrior, bring it back. And then straighten the front leg. Reaching forward, reaching forward. Hand, shin, block or floor. Lengthen your right rib cage out, soften your left rib cage down, wrap the chest open, lengthen out your low back, and then gently shorten from belly button to pubic bone. Breathe into your wings. Here they are. One more inhale. Bend the front knee. Bring the hands around. Pivot around. Take this right foot back. Put it down in front of the left foot. And then come into a staggered foot Vashistasana. Push the inner right foot down. Push the pinky side of the left foot down. So giving yourself a lot of stability. You don't have to make this as much of a balance pose. Keep both legs super strong and kind of squeeze the inner thighs toward each other. Maybe lift up, find a little bit of a side bend, and then chaturanga. As you know, every single chaturanga vinyasa is open to being modified, to being skipped. It's your choice. Left leg back, inhale. Left knee, left tricep, exhale. Inhale back, cross right. Inhale back, place your foot forward. Stay low, arms forward, at the hips with the hands or stretching back. Powerful back leg. So thigh pushes toward the sky, knee pushes toward the sky. Dig the right toes into the ground so that ankle is super awake. Yes. Got me hoping you'll save me right now. Looking so crazy in love. Got me looking so crazy. So I'm going to take my stance a little wider so that I encourage a little better balance here. Take my left foot over to the left a bit. And then start to straighten the front leg. Maybe the hands flow. See how that is received? This side's really tricky for me. And then reverse warrior. Yeah. Beautiful. And then straighten the front leg. And then lengthen out. And triangle. Stay here, breathe. So in reverse warrior, we've got this big side bend. In warrior two, which we haven't done, you're equal in the length of the size of your body. In triangle, we are equal in the length of our sides. So it's like you've gone from here and tipped over. So it's not like a reverse warrior where you're side bending, you're neutral. Does that make sense? That's what it sounds like. I miss making my sound effects in class. I think I've resisted on this platform, but it's time to bring the sound effects back. There we go. Spread your wings, my angels. And that's not a Charlie's Angels reference. because that's sexist. There's no male angels in Charlie's world. And I love all you angels, men and women, non-binary, all of you. Which, if they could redo the original Charlie's Angels now, they really have an opportunity there. I'm just gonna say, they could have had a gay angel, you know, they could have had a non-binary one. I think that we're onto something here. Anybody wanna make this happen? Bring the arm around. You're gonna step it back. Come onto the pinky side of the right foot. Step the left foot in front of the right foot. And then let's find that Vashisasana. And as it feels good, if you're ready, now we get this big side bend. So there's always opportunities to find some of the things that we want to do in certain poses that we don't want in certain poses. Like, I don't want that side bend in triangle, even though it happens sometimes and that's okay, but I do want it here. So lifting, chaturanga, move through and come into downward facing dog. Smooth out your breath. Lift your heels, inhale. Bend your knees, look forward. Come right into chair pose. So bring your feet to your hands and go right into chair. Yes, yes, yes. So just a little different transition. And then maybe start to sink a little deeper. Keep the toes down. We're gonna find our way onto our backs. So if this is not an option for you, you find your way there however you can. Bring your knees right into your triceps, push your feet into each other. Keep the knees at the triceps, curl the shoulders up. Prenatal, head is down, spine is more neutral. Everybody else, if it's okay, shoulders are up. So I'm giving more prenatal options because I got some mamas to be taking my classes. They're not only for prenatal. Like if there's something, if this doesn't feel good, sometimes these are just better places to be for our bodies. So you can follow those, whether or not you are prenatal. But if you're good with your shoulders up, that's where we're going. Knees into triceps, we're just holding here. Big toes together. Pull the heels toward your sitting bone and then curl the hips up off the ground. Breathe. You know this is crow, right? Of course you do. Keep breathing, don't stop. Inhale, head releases, arms reach overhead, legs extend out, find neutral. Exhale, draw in, curl up, hands up. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale. Exhale. You get the idea. Keep moving like that with your breath. Fine tune it. I don't care how big it is, like how high you lift up. It's the intention. It's how you move, the intention with which you move, the message that you are sending from your brain to your body here. You're enough. You're perfect. What you're doing is beautiful. If you're thinking anything other than that, say that. This is amazing. I'm amazing. My movement's good. Maybe this is challenging, but I'm good. I'm doing it. Or maybe I'm pausing because maybe I need a break. But whatever it is that you're choosing to do is perfect. And then fine tune it. Even though it's perfect, fine tune it a little more. That's how we do. We appreciate where we are, yet we still strive to improve. And when I say strive to improve, sometimes that means that we take a step back. That's an improvement sometimes. So notice how you take my words and how they process through. And if you think that that means that you're supposed to work harder, that doesn't mean that. Good, last two. Ah, so good. Hug your knees into your chest. Give yourself a squeeze, release the head down. Pause. Take your hands to your right hamstring. Straighten that right leg out. Extend the left leg. And you're gonna come up. We're here. Or something like that. This leg is floating. If it's okay, Maybe you start to find the foot. Depends on how this hamstring feels. Keep working your center. Really nice. Stretch the left leg away. Mamas, you're just going to release your leg and lie down. Everybody else, we're going to try to keep that leg and come back. So like a reverse ab curl coming down. My left leg is still floating off the ground. Instead of cranking your leg toward your face, imagine I'm standing above you. I've got my hands on your ankle and I'm just lifting gently the leg out of the hip socket to then draw it back. So you can kind of traction yourself a little bit, like lift the leg up, lift it up, lift it up, and then gently back. Never cranking toward your face, please. If there's one thing you let go of that. It's a great way to jack up the attachment of your hamstring. Good, take the back of the left leg. Push, 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 rise up. Right leg is floating. It can be down if it needs to be. If it's appropriate, you'll keep the leg and you'll roll down like a reverse ab crunch. If you need to, you'll come down slowly. You'll refine the leg. And then let's find that same sense of tractioning this leg up and out of the hip socket and then gently supporting. For today, I'm keeping my shoulders and my head up just to stay a little more active here. You can keep your head down, especially prenatal. Yes, yes. Both knees in, hold the backs of the hamstrings. Push, 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 rise up, Navasana. Can we find some of that length here? Knees can still be bent, but if it's okay, you're gonna lift. Be my angel, spread those wings. Cross your shins, down dog or Vinyasa. Inhale, right leg back. Right knee, right tricep. Exhale, all the breath, little pause. Feel that roundness, feel that connection. Inhale, back. Exhale, cross. Inhale, back. Exhale, place your foot forward. Bend the front knee, straighten the back leg, reach the arms forward. Pick up the front toes, maybe hands float. Oh, it wasn't happening for me. And then reverse warrior, take it back. Straighten the front leg, reach forward. If you like a shorter stance, go ahead, shorten up the stance. Trikonasana, triangle. Left hand down. Step the right foot back in front of the left leg. Lift up and open with the hips. Come around, chaturanga. The same sequence we did before. It's in you, find something new. Left leg back, inhale. Left knee, left tricep, all the breath out, pause, feel this shape. Inhale, back, and then cross. Inhale, back, place your foot. Reach forward with the arms, bend the front leg, strengthen the back leg, and then straighten the front leg, lift the toes up, maybe float the hands, and then reverse warrior. Yes! Straighten the front leg, adjust your stance if needed. Triangle. Release the hand, right hand down. Left foot in front of right, Vashisthasana with a big lift. And then Chaturanga. Rise, open. Downward facing dog, exhale. Inhale, lift your heel. Bend your knees. Coming right into chair pose. Bring your feet to your hands, sink right into it. Lift your heels, outer ankles in, start to come into a toe stand. You can always stay here. You can always stay in chair. Bring your hands to the ground if you want. You knew we were coming into crow because we just worked all those muscles on the ground. So that same sense that you had on the ground. Curling the sitting bones toward the heels, heels toward the sitting bones, rounding the upper back. It's the same shape. Hip forward and then lift your legs. Or not, you can stay right here. If you have a block at home, if you stand on the block on the lowest height, for most of us, the lowest height is appropriate. You bring your knees onto your triceps, you're in your crow, still supported, and it kind of gives you that sense of where you want to be without actually leaving the ground because you've got the block. Come back into chair, feet down. Yes. Inhale, rise up, pick up your right knee. Take your hands to your knee. Push your knee forward, stand up tall. Try not to push forward and lean back. Stand up tall. Stay here, setting the shoulders in place. Maybe take that right leg out and hold. Both hands on the knee or on the foot. Arms up, leg out. Crawl taller, be an angel. Breathe into those backside ribs. Push the leg through with control. Standing splits on your left leg. So we have not changed the standing leg. Melt down, lift up. Inhale, pull your heart forward. Bend your left knee and plant your hands on the ground. Good. Take this right leg around and just see if you can sink down and take the right leg out. I'm gonna show you that one more time. We went from here, leg comes around and out. It's not as easy as I'd like to make it be. I know it's challenging. You're killing it. Don't worry, you're killing it. Confidence. Come back up and then chair pose. Toe stand. Stay in chair, stay in toe, stand or bring your hands down, knees into your triceps. Heart forward, keep the hips high to start. So maybe just tip. And then we start that process. Think of this as that crunch we did on our back. We start to pull the sitting bones and the heels toward each other. You're rounding the upper back in the shape of cats. Awesome. Hug the elbows in toward each other, pull the thumbs toward each other, feet come back down to the ground, chair. Left knee lifts up, both hands to the knee. Push the knee forward, stand up as tall as you can. Mm-hmm. This is perfect. When I say that, I hope you believe me. This is perfect. This does not have to change. This is a different pose or a different variation on the pose. Take the leg out if you want, but you were already perfect. So if this creates suffering or negative self-talk, let it go. It being the pose. And then by way of letting go of the pose, let go of that negative self-talk. Don't limit yourself. Do not limit yourself. Be safe, but don't limit yourself. Be confident, arms up, leg out. And then standing splits. Left leg goes back, your right leg is your standing leg. Good. Start to bend the right knee and just turn a little bit on an angle, hopefully to give you a new angle. Think chaturanga in the arms. So pull the thumbs toward each other. Think crow pose in the arms. Bring this left leg around and out to the left arm. Yeah. Good. Take it back. Come back into chair. Inhale. And forward fold. Exhale. 5 breaths in forward fold. If you prefer having your feet at hips distance, go for it. Balance your weight in your feet. Allow your spine to get heavy and long. Inhale, come halfway. Vinyasa or simply downward facing dog. Inhale, right leg back. Right knee to right tricep. Stay here, breathe. Option to extend this leg out, to tip forward and lift up. Left leg down, inhale, right leg up. Exhale, cross to the left. Extend the right leg, fallen triangle. Open it up. Left hand down. Sweep the right leg up and back. Inhale. Place your foot between your hands. Exhale. Splits or half splits. I know that was like boom. There we go. Splits or half splits. I say this all the time, and I don't know if you believe me. Most days I prefer half splits, even though I can do full splits. Why? Because I feel more activation, opening in my hamstring in the back of that right leg. So if I leave my ego out of it, I'm just not really, I mean, I'm getting some. It's more of like, it's a different pose to me. This feels very, very different. This to me is more of like activating in the hips. It's more of a strength pose to me to be here. Whereas here, I really feel like I'm getting length in my spine. I'm opening again the back from the heel to the sitting bone of that right leg. So go in knowing what your intention is. And you might feel it totally different than me. Going into a full split for you might be a much bigger stretch. So honor whatever it is that you're looking for, but know why you're going there. So just because you can do something doesn't mean that you have to, or that it might even be the right thing on any given day. But it could be. That's where confidence and inner teacher take over. If you're in a full split, draw the leg back and then bend the right knee. Turn the left foot over to the left. Right arm comes to the inside of this right leg or right foot, all that good stuff. Use a block if you need it, or put your arm on your thigh if you need it. Rolling open here. We're gonna keep the hand on the hip today. So this is just a version of Parsva Konasana. Side angle, Parsva Konasana. Options, stay here, open up, keep the arm here, maybe wrap it, or maybe bring this shoulder inside of the knee. Reach down for your right foot with your left hand, and then start to open up. Yeah. So good, I see you. Good. If you're here, maybe turn it. Come back into Kundalini. We're all going to meet in downward facing dog, however you want to get there. And then pause. Receive. Left leg back, inhale. Left knee, left tricep, all the breath out. Stay or float it up. Inhale, up and back. Exhale, cross. Fallen triangle.
Now you're just another loaded memory. Nothing we can do about it. Even when your bag is empty, even when your
right hand back down. Sweep the left leg up and back. Full splits, half splits, you decide. We're here for a few breaths because I talked for a while on the other side, so I'm not going to talk a lot on this side. Instead, breathe, notice your pattern of thoughts, receive feedback. Last few breaths, if you're in a full split, draw the left leg back carefully and then bend the front knee. Turn the right foot over to the left. Move the left hand to the inside of the left foot, arm to the inside. Bring your hand on the right side to your right hip. Mm-hmm. Just open. Good. So start to feel this leg connect. Mm-hmm. Maybe you slide the arm under, the arm and back, and you take a wrap here. Maybe you start to move the shoulder inside more. You line that hand up a little bit better. Bend the front leg, reach down for the foot. So this might be the first step, and I didn't do this on the first side, sorry about that. And then you push to open. Big side bend. And then if you want, you can come back to a Kundalini. And then all the way through. Vinyasa into downward facing dog. Fantastic. Smooth out your breath. Take a moment here. You're amazing. In case you forgot. Mm-hmm. Right leg back in half. Right foot outside your right hand. Good. Pause. Pull the heart forward. Bring your left knee. This is like Simon says. Simon says bring your left knee. Maeve says bring your left knee to your left tricep. Your left knee to your left tricep. You can put the left toes down. I'm going to turn on an angle here. Left knee is on left triangle. Right foot was outside of right hand. Push into your hands, lift your left foot up. So this is just a narrow variation on Bakasana. If you're doing that, you've got 3 points of contact. You've got your right foot down, you have both of your hands down. So in a lot of ways, much easier, right? Oh, I've got all sorts of strength here. Then start to pick up the right leg and straighten it out. Or not. Good. And then come through crow if you want, malasana. That was fun, right? I know it was. So it's just another version of bakasana. So I'm gonna give you a straight on view so you can see it. And I'm not saying that my version is great by any stretch. This is really hard for me. And this is like, it's like a half bakasana, half titivasana, half crow, half firefly. I think it's called bakasana too. I don't know if someone made that up in the past 10 years or if this is like anything that was taught way back when. So I'm gonna show it to you one more time. So we step to the foot outside, knee to tricep, foot comes up, and then you start to take that leg out. Yeah? You're in malasana. Release the hands down, square off the feet, first two fingers and thumbs. Wrap the big toes. Padangusthasana, pull the heart forward, push the toes down, and then elbows wide to fold. Inhale, pull the heart forward. Release your hands, bring your feet together, chair pose. Stay here. We're gonna shift into your hands. Little hop. Chair to hop. Keep the knees bent the whole time so that when you land back down, you're right into chair. I'm actually not even like really pushing off my feet. I'm not straightening the legs, or I'm not trying to straighten the legs much more. Next time, chaturanga. Rise open. And down dog. Give all of that wonderful nonsense on the second side. Left leg back, inhale. Left knee, left tricep. Place your foot outside of your left hand. You kind of move your hand in a little bit to start to move your center inward. Maeve says, right knee to right tricep. You don't have to go anywhere. This is amazing. Hug the elbows and pull the thumbs toward each other. You've now achieved a half of a bakasana. If you haven't floated off the ground, look, you got your foot up. If you want, extend that left leg out. Yes, Janelle. And then malasana. Yeah, so good. Release your hands down, come to chair. We're gonna do that again. You can either stay here, this is perfect, or if you want, and then maybe we start to take this little kick up a little higher. Still landing in chair when you come down. Two more. And then feet at hips distance. Foot to hand pose, Paddhasthasana. Whole hand under your foot, and then melt down. Stretch out those wrists. Inhale, heart forward. Release your hands to your hips. Rise up to stand. Good. Bring the feet just a smidge closer together. Turn the palms open. Receive your breath. Close your eyes or soften the gaze. Rise up, inhale. Angel wings up, forward fold, exhale. Halfway, bend your knees, come onto your backs. Right away, elbows, triceps, shoulders press down, feet press down, knees move toward your toes energetically to lift the hips up. Think about that. Knees move forward away from your face toward the toes, to lift the hips up. And then belly button to sky. One more inhale. Release with your exhale. We're gonna repeat bridge. Option to take one leg up. Option to go into upward facing bow. and take one leg up or not. So all just options. Inner teacher, confidence right now. Inhale, rise. If you're taking the leg up, pull the knee up first and then extend. We're gonna hold the duration with one leg and then we'll take our last back bend, at which time you will do the other side if you're doing one side. Foot comes down if it's up, with care, all the way down. Receive that. Note if there's any adjustments you need to make. Note if you don't need another back bend, in which case you have the confidence to sit this one out. Rise up. So confidence gives us the ability to make good choices because we're not worried about what our inner voice is saying, like, why didn't you do more? And we're not worried about what anyone else thinks. Your inner voice is part of your confidence. You feed it. And then foot down, and then release down. Happy baby. If you want, extend the legs out straight. We're moving into a forward fold. You can come up to forward fold. You can stay on your back, draw the legs up. You can come into plow pose. If you are in a seated forward fold, rise up, roll down onto your backs. If you are in plow, start to roll down slowly. We're all gonna take a fish pose together. So, keep the legs all the way out straight. Bring your hands next to your hips, push the elbows down, lifting up head. Bring the very top of the head down to the floor, open up your throat. You're not pushing against the head, you're resting the head lightly down. The elbows are supporting you. Your breath is supporting you. Push down, release the head. Take a pause, hand to heart, hand to belly. Receive. Reach the arms overhead, slide the feet in, soles of the feet together, knees drop open, Supta Baddha Konasana. And then bring the arms around and put them on the inner thighs gently. You're not pushing the legs down, please. You're just resting. So it's like you've got this little bit of extra weight. Last full breath here. You're gonna take your left hand to your outer left thigh, lift the leg all the way over to the right, take the left arm out to the side, simple twist. And then reverse it, knees to the left, right arm out to the side. And then center, Shavasana. Release the legs out. Adjust anything that needs adjusting. Your pants, your top. I always feel like I need to get all that square so that there's no reason to do it once you have settled. I like to rock my hips a little side to side. Your feet flop. Your legs get heavy. Maybe push the elbows down, lift the chest up a little bit, the shoulders up, and then release the shoulders heavy into the ground. backs of the hands to the floor, palms, fingertips to the sky. Lengthen out the back of your neck. Soften the chin gently toward the chest. Relax your lips. Relax your jaw. Take any tension out of your teeth. Release your forehead, your scalp, your inner ears. Breath starts to quiet and slow. Start the process of first deepening the breath. And then from the breath, reawakening the belly, the ribs, the heart center, the throat. As the body wakes back up, let that awareness transfer into your limbs. And then start the process of moving back to seated. And find your the way there, however your body wants to come up. Bring your hands to your heart once you've arrived there. Taking this confidence, this attention to breath, to body, to mind, off of your mat. That's what the practice is. It's not just when we're on our mat. The practice is, how does this translate into the world, into all things that we do? The patterns that we create here, it's not about dropping into a split in the middle of a meeting, right? It's about how we respond to other people, how we allow our ego to get in the way, how we allow our confidence to drive us, but to give us the confidence to be a beginner, to have new eyes, to find something new. Inhale, draw real, real tall. Exhale, bow your mind to your heart. Thank you so much for sharing your practice with me today. I love you all. Have a great day.